matter where the girls can find me.
You and Ramsey, yeah?
Yeah, Ramsey, yeah.
The
stew chicken is nice. Normally I have stew chicken from other places. I don't really like it. The flavour is not too there. It's kind of bland, but here, the taste of flavour, the texture. The service is good here. People are friendly. You know, when you got friendly people, it's even better. Yeah.
Jerk chicken and pasta.
This is what I saw. This up in the A-Train. Brilliant. If you haven't seen it, go see it.
Come on! When I come to... I've been to all around the UK. When I come to Luxor Junction, I am feeling very happy to come to my home.
Yeah?
Yeah. I like this area. But I run this business from last 15 years. Yeah, it's a very good area now. But the beginning was a little bit trouble there. But not in my shop, because I start my business from here. From 15 years in this corner, yeah. In 2003. This is my local shop. Yeah. They come to me. Yeah. Very happy people. Yeah. Enjoy the life. Very good.
Yes, sir.
Don't look there. That guy is my cousin.
On the left?
Yeah, on the left. His name is Abid Ali.
Yeah, I used to just live down the road there. I had a shop down on Kangaroo Road.
Is it?
Yeah, hydro shop.
What do you think of this big screen here?
It's right, isn't it? save electricity indoors, yeah. It'll come in here.
I've got a cat. My cat loves me. My cat's cool, brother. He's indoors. He's thinking about the Arsenal.
Right, see you later.
Don't try.
There used to be people all drinking outside or something. Mm-hmm. Like, it was fucking chaos out there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Rumble MC. I just wrote a little 16 about Loughborough Junction, and this is it. Loughborough J, love on a sunny day, bopper left on five ways, roll through estate, link with a couple mates, no time to waste, living in this in-between place, southeast, southwest, jamming with my bros and my babes. Only thing I will say is making a community change, yeah, catching some beautiful waves, take estate agents away, I don't like their taste, stuck at my mom's place, but that's a blessing anyway. Big up life in Loughborough J, Loughborough Junction, that's how we function. Oh.
I don't let nobody get to me now.
Yeah.
I had a few idiots come in here and try it. Like, try to tell you they're going to stab you and do like, and tell. Even one geezer come in here, and because I wasn't doing the business with him, he said, look, I kill people, you know. I kill people. Anyway, he didn't have a hoodie on, and I give him some argument, and he went away. And he come back, put on the scarf around his face, and whatever not. He says, look, I'll kill it. With his hand in his pocket, like, look, I'm a killer. I said, look, you're a fool. First you come in here without a hoodie. Now you're coming back with your face all brother carver up and tell me you're going to kill me again. I said, you're an idiot. Now me and him is a best friend. We are the best friend.
Welcome to the Grove Adventure Playground. Check out this absolutely magnificent structure. We've got a wonderful tire swing. We can do a terrible demonstration of play, basically. So I'm working here to facilitate free open access adventure playgrounds. There's an absolutely incredible team here at Grove Adventure Playground. Massive numbers of volunteers who've worked incredibly hard to get this place up and running again. It has been shut down for a good, at least I think, 3 years, and LJAG, which is Loughborough Junction Action Group, basically got us, got it reopened and got the lease for play for 3 years, so at least 3 years, so we are open.
She's the boss, trust me.
Of course she's the boss. There's nothing wrong with that. Of course she's the boss. And say, listen, boss, I need to talk to you about something. And this is it, boss. Right now, these tools is what I use to make life easy for you and I.
Yeah.
These tools contribute not just to me, but to you as well.
In the house, anything that is not
in the appropriate place.
Not anything that is not where she put it, it's not in the appropriate place.
That's right.
She has to put it there.
So my friend, you have to take responsibility for not putting your tools in the appropriate place. And now you come to me with the headache. Okay, take care, have a good day.
Brother, thank you. Much appreciated. Bye.
Hispanic products. These are all from Colombia, Ecuador, Salvador, all these places. This is actually Ecuadorian corn, not like, oh shit. The Jamaican people, their accents are really strong. So I remember when I first started, some people would come in and say, let me get 3 pound on my oyster. And I would just sit there like, what? What do you want? What? How much? I don't understand. And then eventually you kind of just learn. The longer you're here, the more you learn, the more you grasp, and you get used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, when people, there's a great Kinatari, the man who owned a blessed restaurant in Cola Adelaide.
Yeah, man, I said, Doyla, blessed.
The man who dressed like it's fun. The man who keep the place colorful every day. When there are good people, that's a legend, you know.
Can I have it? No, just give it to me cold. I'll warm it when I get home.
Brixton was like a Hollywood man. You know, I said every day you wake up, it's like everybody was looking as fabulous and
yeah.
Nice. Everybody just up in suits and sheepy suit, and the girls were just up in pleated skirt. And Brixton was like, you're on a movie set. Every day you wake up, it's like, you're on a movie set, man. I'm telling you, it was a place to be, man. Where if you come from the hero, you know about Loughborough Junction. You live in freaking fucking world as well, man. Anything you do, you must just capture the moment, you know.
Yeah.
You have a brother. Love people feel this energy, that's why people come. So when you have good spirit, whether you're black or you're white, people draw to your spirit. So that's why I tell you that bossy, bold spirit. I'm just So every morning, if you die on my camera, it's serious thing on your money, my friend. Newton, you're going to give a shout out?
A record for an England player, male.
Shout out to everybody, man. Tell them to come to the barber shop.
You always get a good service, yeah?
Most definitely, man. You come here looking ugly and then you go back home looking fresh.
I've never got my hair cut in a barber's ever.
Right.
My mum cuts our hair. Money as well, I've saved probably about, what, 100 grand on haircuts over my lifetime.
Say something.
Characters, eh?
What's your highlight of the junction?
I really liked it when it was Eastern Tree. It's a really nice Vietnamese restaurant. That's where I first went. Got drunk in there, you know. I used to drink in there quite a lot when I was like your age, actually, 16, 17, I reckon. And really good food, but they shut down. Then a Brazilian place sprouted up. They got shut down, and now it's the Junction. The Junction.
Practicing. I was in like just like I don't want to be here mode. I had a class yesterday and it was so good. Really, really good.
A dance class?
Yeah. In Port Brixton. So it was my last one for this month.
What was so good about it?
Just the energy and the fact that new people are coming. Not everyone's that confident. But it's just a nice insight to see different people. I have after I dance, like sometimes I go to dance and I feel really anxious, and this is me just talking the truth, I feel anxious, like, oh my god, what's gonna happen? But then once I dance and I just express myself, I'm like, oh my god, look at all these people here that are happy and they feel good, and that's just what I want. I want it to show on the outside but make sure they feel good inside.
Yeah.
Yeah, I recognise you, man. That's good.
The stuck-up sound system,
we're
boys.
We're here live and direct.
I was 16 when I bought my first turntables, and that was when my mum was like, you're going to have to take all your money and buy it yourself because I'm going to buy it for you. It's too expensive. That house there, number 8, Odin House, that house right there, we used to run a power cable all the way along here into that number, Gary, that 17 one on the end. I go by Flaxman. Yeah, Flaxman's my DJ name. Because we play a lot of reggae and roots music, and it's all about kind of your roots and your culture, where you're born and you're raised. You have to stick to your roots, and kind of Flaxman Road is where I learnt my trade, my music.
You have a first kiss in this playground?
Nah, man, the girls are rough around here. The girls are rough around here. One take, all the way, yeah? Boom, there you go. Have some of that. It was Loughborough Junction at its finest. Cool. Respect, man. Ciao for now, yeah, man. Look after yourself.
What are you growing?
Come, let me show you. This is living potato. We're ready, a lot of potato in the ground. So when you come here 3 months from now, you will see all them corn come up to the height of here.
And what do you do with the corn?
Give it to people. Go sell it. Please, 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 get together, because we're going to do something about the knife and gun crime. Them don't know no better. If they get both parents together, God Almighty, it must make a difference. This is what I'm here for. I'm glad you come. Louis.
This is called a lake. This is on still waters, feeling deep beneath the layers where we sleep, beneath the tables, underground, or beneath all din of man-made sound. The waters weep and ebb forth tales of ancient myths inscribed on snails, of splashed crustaceans bearing name where creation's ancient music came and spoke its sound into the core of sendings forth from heaven's door. Far greater octave spans than ours, a busy seeding fireworks from out space, turning into human flowers.
When the lights go out, you're dead, cuz. Simple. And until then, just live nicely with everybody. Live, don't put your hat where you can't take it down. And enjoy life, cuz. Enjoy life, man.
Those are characters, yes. It was no boxing gym, there was nobody there, well, art studios, it was nothing. It was all just scrap, everything metals, everything scrap. Sometimes people come along, they want to park here, they say, you're not allowed to park. I said, what? So you get loads of characters, you know, you get some brain damage sometimes, which they don't want to listen to you. You say that I'm paying rent here, I got customers, they're waiting. So please, you fucking idiot, you just, for fucking hell.
This is Maria. Maria, 1 second, please. This is Maria. He does arty stuff.
Yeah.
All the arts.
I'm a painter.
Obviously, we do clothes and shit. You see what I'm saying?
crust buns, homemade cake.
You want to put something on and feel good, get a bit of like energy. You just get a sign here because these is original. Well, you get me. I'm working hard. You know, make Jay Huss look lazy. Make the hustler look lazy.
You want to remain in Europe?
Yes, of course. Yeah. We ain't stupid.
German beer is the best. You know Brexit.
It's a joke.
Hey, there can't be Carlsberg. Oh, hey, Nikki, what's up with you? That's gonna get here on time. You might not get your medication on time,
yeah,
but trust me.
Get that in time.
Carlin, hey, Nikki.
He's
gonna reach right here on time.
On time.
But we'd be a bit sad if you know what I mean. It'd be a sad outcome if we don't get be it on time when they need it. And if the pubs run out, come on. It's gonna be naughty. Particularly in Brixton, they're gonna be naughty. Yeah.
So I moved here about just over 2 years ago, and I always walk past it. It's actually a community allotment, so volunteers come up and volunteer for a few hours. We plant some like chard or cabbage, and then you get to take some produce home. But it's also kind of just like a space for, like, I don't know, people to like potter around and be like calm and quiet.
Yeah, so sweet peas, you recognise?
Yeah, what's all the word?
Do you know that there is a next week there is a movie about the farm?
So it's on Thursday.
Oh!
Shoveling.
You're the original! Come on!
The man in the manor. Okay.
You know what I mean? But I love myself. I don't get in trouble because. And I'm a ragamuffin. I am a ragamuffin. Yeah.
Because you see from there, at some point, if you manage when there aren't any cars, you can connect the bridge with the other bridge, and it makes a nice image. So with the bridge over there, connecting with the painted bridge,
yeah.
So it's a continuous line. And yeah, so we're looking a bit at the history of the place. And if you look, there's a website about the hidden or lost railway stations in London. And there's a photograph, which is actually that image, with a guy on the bicycle, actually. And it's an image from... Is it 1936, something like that? So it's just a guy on a bicycle just turning the corner and going up that way. And it's a really nice experience to work outdoors, no? That's yeah. What my experience. And you see lots of crazy things as well. I mean, there was one of their painting, and there were two chaps here from the States as well in the area, and there was kind of a fight in the middle of the street. And so you get to see also by working there, so you're suddenly in the middle of the street and the stories. And you know, some are good, some are bad, but it's all part of the what it is in there.
Hey?
What did you watch last night?
100 Vaginas on Channel 4. So there's this female photographer, and she's actually photographing vaginas and talking to the women who own the vaginas and exploring the relationship that women have with their vaginas. And there was one particular woman started to talk about her vagina, and she goes, yeah, my vagina, and she talks about it as a she, and she said there'll be a certain time of the month where she obviously is ready to receive, and all of a sudden it just gets really full and it wants something. And of course this is the biological drive to get impregnated, and it just takes over everything. And here I am at 58 and I hear this. And just like you just said there, yeah, of course, we forget that they have this month thing going on. And we're completely oblivious to it as men. Oblivious. We don't realise the importance of this, that there are certain times of the month. You're in, mate!
Miguel Zach, there could be some negative connotations around Brixton, Loughborough, Archway, Boxing Gym, the little alleyway walk to the gym, like thinking of that, and it's dark. Thinking of that alone is like, ooh, scary. Sounds like a horror movie or something. Well, the minute you step through those doors, you see smiles. There's just warm embrace, there's hugs, the way we greet each other. People are happy to see each other. People, happy to be together. It's the friendliest gym in England. It's
like, ciao! Right, jazz.
That's Grace right there, yeah? Dangerous!
Grace.
Dangerous! Yeah. If she invites you to the ring, get your passport and just leave the country. Leave the gym. Dangerous! Hey, don't let that smile fool you, yeah? This is like the champion staircase. When you want to become a champion, you need to walk up these staircases, right? Everyone who walks up these stairs are champions. Yeah?
Is that right?
Champion.
Yeah, man. I already walked up the stairs.
Champ.
This man has mentored more people than you see on your way to work in the morning. Yeah. He's mentored more people. Father figure for many. Uncle figure for many. I've known him since I was like 14, 15, and no matter how many times I went away, no matter how many times I wasn't serious, always have faith in us, always have the time to teach and empower us, and this is why I am where I am today. So I just like to say to you on camera, I love you, man! Hey,
didn't you know, yeah? The famous barman of Loughborough Junction.
Best looking barman of Loughborough Junction. Well, I'd say like the main thing which is amazing, I think, with the Junction is this very community spirit. You know, there's like, there's just all the locals, the lovely different characters that you get in here. Everyone just come and stop and have a chat. No matter if they're strangers or anything like that, they'll still just come and have a chat and speak to them and have a drink, yeah. A beer or something. So I think that's what like makes it stand out.
Oh! I don't usually wear glasses. Last week I went to the youth climate strike, and it was nice to see so many, kids out there, but it's like tragic, you know?
It's like if I collect them. It's not to put them on shelves. It's just that if I'm single, I'm just dreaming that someone is holding me. I've always been ready to hate them or to tell them what to do, but I love them all. And today I'm thinking they are gentle. Tonight I'm gonna sleep in a bed that smells like us. And he told me, I'm gonna fuck you. Deeply and slowly, as you asked. He said, tonight is the night. I met that guy that says that he is half women.
Be a development of flats, presumably, yes, in the next few years or so, yes.
Yeah.
So everybody will be moving very shortly, in that sense. Look, for this building here, it's coming to its end for what we're using it for now, but what is it going to become?
Who knows? Maybe a restaurant. Who knows? Depends how the area transforms itself in general. But it will be very interesting to know. Yeah. But unfortunately, some people have to suffer. You do your work, you go, yes, you miss the people in the area. But eventually, good thing comes to an end. Even though they're just next door. Remember, if that was also a nursery. And now it's like flats. Just next door. And as I said, just behind us here, we got the mechanics. Now he's gone now. Yeah. And then the upstairs, I think, with the Nation of Islam, they're going also. So the tire shops and the mechanic also, they're going up completely. So they've gone. Yeah. The car wash across the road, that's going eventually also, because that's been sold. The area is very nice. You know, you cannot fault the area for anything. You just have to live with time. You know, as I said, we can't stay forever, but you try and make it as good as you can. It started to change drastically. Now it starts to change drastically, because before it was in the pipeline. But when it comes to, now it's hitting us now, because you see things now popping up, boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I mean, like around the corner used to be open field, but now it's like a workspace, it's a farm, and that used to be a toilet just around the corner here, toilet.
A public toilet?
Yeah, but now it's a calf. So that's
just it. What's this Bob Marley thing?
The guy that was here before us, because this is a bit of car wash. Yes, here. And they put that up there. Mirror it off. So that's all it's been there.
Favourite Bob Marley song?
All of them. I don't say it's not all of them. Because all of them carry a little weight of something, you know. That's one thing about Bob Marley's tunes. They all carry something. There's something he says in there. It depends on your mood. You know, but there's something in there.
Yourself to find yourself.